we are going to see about GTO. Okay, so GTO means gate turn off thyristor. Okay, gate turn off thyristor is a special kind of thyristor, and it is invented by the General Electric GE company. Okay, and apart from that normal thyristor, GTO is different in such a way that it is a fully controllable switch in which turn off and turn on can be controlled by using a gate signal. We have seen in the power MOSFET power MOSFET and IGBT that turning on process is by using a gate signal, and also in thyristors also thyristors are turned on by using a gate signal. Okay, but in case of turn off, it is not turned off by using a gate signal. So here means it will be half control switch, thyristor and that IGBT and power MOSFET and all. Here in the case of GTO, it is a fully controllable switch in which we can turn on and turn off this GTO by using a gate signal. By using the gate signal, we can turn on and turn off this GTO. Okay, so it is a fully controllable switch, and similar to other device, it is a three-terminal four-layer device. Three terminals are the and four layer PN four layer junction. Okay, four layer device. Okay, three junctions will be there, and also it is used in chopper and PWM inverter applications. Okay, these are the basics about GTO. So it is a special kind of thyristor, and it is invented by General Electric company, and it is a fully controllable switch. This is the major difference. It is a fully controllable switch in which turn on and turn off can be controlled by using a gate signal. Similar to other device, it is a three terminal four layer device, and mainly it is used in chopper and PWM inverter applications. Okay, and this is the circuit symbol of this GTO. Here anode is there, here cathode is there, here gate is there. Here previously in lower classes you might have seen SCR, silicon control rectifier. Here if this this line is not there, means it will be similar as that of SCR. So if you are putting this line, this symbol becomes of GTO. Okay, anode, cathode and gate, these are the three terminals. Okay, and similarly this is also denoted as symbol for GTO. Here you can see this arrow mark pointing in both sides. It means by using this gate signal, we can turn on and turn off this GTO. Okay, that is what this arrow mark is pointing about. Both sides it is showing, means it can be turned on and turned off. Okay, so this is the circuit symbol of GTO. Three terminals are anode, cathode, this side is cathode and gate. Okay, and GTO can be turned on by using a positive gate pulse, and GTO can be turned off by using a negative gate pulse. So if you are giving a positive gate pulse with respect to cathode, and if it crosses the threshold voltage, this GTO can be turned on. Here gate is there, cathode is there. So if gate is positive with respect to cathode, and if it crosses the threshold voltage, then this GTO can be turned on. Similarly, if gate is negative with respect to cathode, and if it crosses the threshold voltage, then this GTO can be turned off. This is the operation of, this is how GTO operates. That is what here gate terminal is there. By applying positive or negative gate pulse, we can turn on and turn off this GTO. If we are applying positive gate pulse with respect to cathode, and if it is crossing the threshold value, this GTO can be turned on. And if we are applying negative gate pulse with respect to cathode, and if it crosses the threshold voltage, this GTO can be turned off. Okay. And another one is GTO is 10 times faster as SCR. Means GTO is faster than SCR means GTO is faster than SCR means switching speed is more in the case of GTO. It is 10 times more faster switching as SCR. Okay, switching speed is faster in GTO when it is compared to SCR. And also for turn off process, this GTO can be connected in parallel, like what we have seen in that power MOSFET and IGBT. This GTO also can be connected in parallel. GTO is also a three terminal four layer device. PN 4 layers are there, and three terminal anode, cathode and gate. And gate is the controllable switch in which we are applying positive gate pulse with respect to cathode. This GTO can be turned on, and if we are applying negative gate pulse with respect to cathode, this GTO can be turned off. Three terminals are anode, cathode and gate. Okay, so this is the basic structure of GTO. Here you can see a P plus region is there, N minus region is there, P region is there, N plus region is there, another one P plus region is there. Here the major difference will be that gate will be connected to, these all are the metallic rod which is connecting this terminal with this semiconductor layer. Gate here also metallic layer, in cathode also metallic layer, and here this anode also metallic layer. It is connected to connected between this terminal and the semiconductor layer. Okay, and here you can see major difference will be here gate is connected to a P plus layer. P plus means highly doped P region. Here also a anode also is connected to a highly doped P plus region, P region, and here is a lightly doped N minus region. Here a moderately doped P region, and cathode is connected to a highly doped N plus region. Okay, so this is the structure of GTO. Here you can see three junctions are there. One junction is the N plus P. This is junction one. second one P N minus junction J2, and N minus P plus, which is junction J3. Okay, and in the last slide we have seen when the gate is positive with respect to cathode, and if it is crossing the threshold voltage, this GTO can be turned on. And gate is negative with respect to cathode, and if it is more than threshold value, this GTO can be turned off. Okay, and also during reverse bias. During reverse bias means here anode and cathode is there. Anode is negative with respect to cathode. Anode is negative with respect to cathode. At that time, you can see this junction J1. J1 is reverse bias, means this N plus P region. Then this junction J2, P N minus junction will be forward bias. Then this junction J3, N minus P plus junction will be reverse bias, because here is negative. Anode is negative with respect to cathode. So here two junctions are reverse bias and one junction is forward bias, and no gate pulse is applied. At that time, what will be happening? No conduction will happen here from between the anode and cathode, because two junctions are reverse bias. And also in other case, when no gate pulse is applied and anode is positive with respect to cathode, here the junction J1, N plus P junction will be forward bias, junction J2, P N minus junction will be reverse bias, and junction J3, N minus P plus junction will be forward bias. Here also this junction J2, it is reverse bias. One junction is reverse bias. So again, no conduction will happen because one of the junction is reverse bias here. Okay. But if you are applying the gate pulse, that if anode is positive with respect to cathode and this junction J2 around will be in reverse bias condition. So if you are applying this gate pulse, it will make, and if it is crossing the threshold voltage, this junction also will become forward bias and the conduction will happen. This is how the GTO will be working. Understood? That is during forward bias condition, anode is positive with respect to cathode. At that time, J1 and J3 will be forward bias, J2 will be reverse bias. So if you are applying gate pulse positive with respect to cathode, means here it is positive and here it is negative, at that time what will happen? If this positive gate pulse crosses the threshold voltage, this J2 junction will make it as forward bias, and thus the conduction will happen between the anode and cathode. Okay, so conduction will takes place, that GTO will be turned on. Okay, that is how the GTO will be working. Okay, when gate pulse positive, positive gate pulse applied with respect to cathode and anode positive with respect to cathode, the GTO is turned on and it will be conducting. That is what I said now. And when negative gate pulse is applied with respect to cathode, and negative gate pulse is applied with respect to cathode, and if it is crossing the threshold value, this GTO will be turned off. And one more thing you have to consider here, the magnitude of the gate voltage should be 1/3. It should be in between 1/3 and 1/5 of anode voltage. So while designing this GTO, it should be taking care, because when it is turning off, this magnitude of this gate voltage, negative gate voltage, should be in between 1/3 to 1/5 of this anode voltage. Okay, that should be taking care while designing this GTO, then only it will be turned off. Okay, understood? So when positive gate pulse is applied with respect to cathode, okay, and it crosses the threshold voltage, this GTO will be turned on. And if negative gate pulse is applied with respect to cathode, and if it is crossing that threshold voltage, that should be 1/3 to 1/5 of anode voltage. So at that time, this GTO will be turned off. Okay, this is how this GTO will be working. Next one is IV characteristics of GTO. Okay, so first we will see how we are going to draw this reverse clocking state. Okay, here graph is between the anode current and anode voltage. Okay, anode current and anode voltage. Okay, so here we will see the reverse bias condition. In this reverse bias condition, we have seen that anode is negative with respect to cathode. Anode is negative with respect to cathode. At that time, this junction N plus P junction, that is junction J1, will be reverse bias, and this junction J2, PN minus junction, will be forward bias. This junction J3, N minus P plus junction, will be reverse bias. Okay, only J2 will be forward bias. So here conduction will be only due to this minority carrier. So here what will happen? This current, this small leakage, this will be a leakage current because of minority carriers. So the current will be, when we increasing the anode voltage, the current will be due to only that leakage current due to the minority carriers. So it will be increasing like this as the voltage increases. So at a particular point, if you are increasing the anode voltage, reverse bias voltage, again and again, at a particular point, breakdown of this junction J1 and J3 will happen. And after that, a large reverse current will be flowing. That is this voltage VBR, breakover voltage, reverse breakover voltage. Okay. So after that reverse breakover voltage, this junction J1 and J3, it will be breakdown and large reverse current will be flowing. Okay. So this is the reverse bias characteristics. Okay. And in forward bias characteristics, we can see here also, anode is positive with respect to cathode. Anode is positive with respect to cathode. At that time, what will be happening when anode is positive with respect to cathode? This junction J1, N plus P junction, will be forward bias. Junction J2, PN minus junction, will be reverse bias. Junction J3, N minus P plus junction, will be forward bias. Okay. So this junction J2 is reverse bias, so no conduction will take place. And the current here will be due to minority carriers of this junction J2, because here no conduction will be taking place, and current will be due to this leakage current due to the reverse bias junction J2. Okay, similarly, what we have seen in reverse bias condition, similar case here also. Here one junction is reverse bias, so conduction will not take place, but a small leakage current will be there. Okay, due to that minority carriers, so that is the current showing here. And further, if you are increasing the forward bias voltage, what will happen? at one point forward breakover will happen. Okay, forward breakover will happen. So at that time, what will happen? This junction J2 here, this junction J2 will be break down, and large reverse, large forward current will be flowing here. See, large forward current will be flowing here. Or otherwise, what will happen here? I will tell. If you are applying that positive gate pulse, it will make this junction J2 forward bias. Okay, when it makes forward bias, what will happen? This conduction will take place between anode and cathode. So large current will be starting flowing from there. Okay, so either if you are increasing the anode voltage, the junction J2, it will be breakdown and the large forward current will starts to flow after that breakdown happens. Or what will happen in between, if you are applying the gate pulse positive with respect to cathode, and if it is crossing the threshold voltage, this it will make this junction J2 forward bias. Thus conduction will happen between anode and cathode, and large forward current will flow here. Okay, that is what the graph shows here. And if you are applying that negative gate pulse with respect to cathode, and if that negative gate pulse, if it is crossing the threshold value, what will happen? Here you can see what will happen here. From here, if you are applying negative pulse, and negative pulse, if it is crossing the threshold value, here this GTO will be turned off. Here you can see the current will be reducing like this from here to here, and only leakage current will be there from. Okay, so if you are applying negative gate pulse with respect to cathode, and if it is crossing the threshold value, the GTO will be turned off. Here you see negative gate pulse, and also that magnitude of that negative gate pulse should be in between 1/3 to 1/5 of anode voltage. At that time, what will happen? That this one GTO will be turned off. That is what you can see. The current is reducing here. Current is reducing here, and only leakage current will be existing from there on. Okay. So these are the IV characteristics of GTO. First reverse blocking state we have seen. Here what will be happening? This junction anode will be negative with respect to cathode. Junction J1 and J3 will be reverse bias, and J2 will be forward bias. No conduction will happen. But here minority carriers are there. So due to this minority carriers, leakage current will be there. So as the anode voltage increases, the current will be only due to that minority carriers, and at a particular point, this J1 and J3 junction will be break down, and large reverse current will be flowing. Okay, so this point where the breakdown happens in J1 and J3 junction, this is breakover voltage, reverse breakover voltage. Okay, so from there onwards, large reverse current will be flowing. And in forward bias state, what will be happening? Anode will be positive with respect to cathode. At that time, J1 and J3 will be forward bias, and J2 will be reverse bias. Okay, so there also initially the current will be due to the flow of minority carriers, because this J2 junction is reverse bias, and thus the conduction will not happen between anode to cathode. So the initial current flow will be due to this minority carriers only. Okay, so as the anode forward bias voltage increases, at one point this junction J2 will be break down, and large forward current will be flowing, starting flowing. Okay, so that point at which this breakdown happens is called forward breakdown voltage, this VBF. Okay, so and also one more thing is there, if we are applying positive gate pulse with respect to cathode, and this positive gate pulse, if it is crossing the threshold value, then also this conduction will happen between anode and cathode, and forward current will be flowing. Okay, and if it is want to turn off, what will be happening? here a negative gate pulse we will be applying with respect to cathode. At that time, if that negative gate pulse is in between 1/3 to 1/5 of anode voltage, this GTO will be turned off. Suddenly you can see here the current will be dropping to this small value. This is minority current value. Okay, thus the GTO can be turned off. Okay, this is the IV characteristics of GTO. And also next one is comparison of SCR and GTO. SCR means silicon controlled rectifier. It is a is also a one of the thyristor, and GTO here you can see both this SCR and GTO, it is of same rating, 1600 volt, 350 ampere. GTO also 1600 volt, 350 ampere. Here we are comparing between on state voltage drop, turn on time, gate current and turn off time. Now we can see turn on time. Okay, not turn on time, turn on voltage drop. Turn on voltage drop in case of SCR it is 1.5 volt, in case of GTO it is 3.4 volt. Means turn on drop in the case of GTO it is more. Turn on drop means this one, this drop is there na, this value, this is the turn on drop. So in case of GTO turn on drop is more, 3.4 volt, but in case of SCR turn on drop is 1.5 volt. Okay, when you are taking 1600 volt, 350 ampere rated thyristor and GTO. Okay, then turn on time. Turn on time is 8 microseconds in SCR, whereas 2 microsecond in GTO. Means turn on time is faster in GTO than that of SCR. Here it is 8 microsecond, here it is 2 microsecond. Then gate current. Gate current, initial gate current required is 200 milliampere in case of SCR, whereas 2 ampere in case of GTO. For GTO, more gate current is required for turning on the GTO. Okay. Then turn off time. Turn off time in case of SCR it is 150 microsecond, whereas in case of GTO it is 15 microsecond. Means turn off is faster in GTO than that of normal SCR. Okay, so these are the major difference between SCR and GTO. Okay, so this is all about GTO, gate turn off thyristor. Okay.